press the bell icon on our YouTube app and never miss another video from Spotboy.
I think for me, the idea came up more because I just bumped into the guys at Saavn at like literally a valet parking, and they were like, "You're really funny and you should have an audio show." And I was just like, I've always wanted to have something that's unfiltered. So yeah, I mean, you know, along with Saavn, I'm the one who like created the show, and with immense support and ideas from Rishi Malhotra, who's the owner of Saavn, and his entire team. So it was really exciting for me to create it. What was really, really flattering was A, the love of the audience, because you can't do anything without, you know, the consumer consuming it. The more important part was the kind of celebs and the guests that I had in season one. They all came without actually knowing what the show was. So I was just like, hey, I'm doing an audio show. Will you come and talk to me for an hour in a room? And even I didn't know what it was going to be, but everyone was just there. It was just been so awesome. Like, I can't tell you, like, my season one is always going to be precious to me. I think, so what we do is our research team, like, it's just literally not even a team. It's like one person who brings out all the research from Google, from the internet, from everywhere else, and then gives it to me and my writer. Actually, so I have this great writer called Mansi. She's pretty fabulous. The girl on research is this lovely girl called Sharanya. So Sharanya will take out the research, and then I'll be like, all this is not going to be asked. Then Mansi gets down to making the questions, and then I, in the meanwhile, will cold call people. So I call like whoever's coming, their friends and their brothers and their sisters and their guests and, you know, and their, sorry, not guests, but, you know, their childhood friends. So it's just a mix of the kind of people who come. So on the show, but more importantly, I'm just doing intense research, and sometimes the stuff that comes out in the research is so funny and so unadulterated that I have to hold back and I can't even ask the guests. You know, it's a tough one. It's always a catch-22, but I think that, you know, as guests on my show, they come and then it's just, you know, two chairs, two mics and a room. So it's definitely a space where people get very, very comfortable, also because of me and because we've known each other, you know, and people who come on the show at some point, even if it's a really big star, they've seen me around in the business for almost 15-16 years. So they get very comfortable, but they know that they're responsible for the things that they say. And we never talk about personal life. We never talk about professional life. We talk about everything between personal and professional. So that's what makes it really, really interesting. And I mean, the media picks it up, but we wouldn't be anywhere without the help and support of the media. I'm sure they get affected when they see stuff in the papers, and it's always the headline. We are never misrepresented, but there's always a fun, quirky headline that'll like bother you. For instance, when I was giving a No Filter interview right now, somebody asked me about what would you like to produce next, and I was like, and they were like, the question was different, and the answer I gave to a different question was, yeah, 50 Shades of Grey, if the India version was made, Alia and Sid would be great. But the headline was that Neha wants to produce 50 Shades of Grey with Sid and Alia. So I'm just saying that, you know, things being blown out of proportion, it's normal, but then it comes and goes, it passes by. I think I do so much, even otherwise. I'm, you know, I'm on TV, I'm, you know, a part of a reality show, I'm, you know, a presenter, I'm now a producer. I'm also an actor. I just finished doing another film where I'm, again, not playing the lead, but I'm playing a part in a film with Vidya Balan. So, you know, the thing is that when the opportunity is so much that you can't fight for that one thing that isn't really coming your way the way you want it to. Whereas when there are other things that are coming your way the way you want it to, so then you just make sure that it's a mixed bag and then it looks as good. So yeah, I'm doing multiple things, but as a solo lead, if I'm doing a film, nothing yet. If something amazing comes my way, I will. Last year, I had a film called Mo Maya Money that released in November. And that was a solo lead. But if it's independent cinema and if it's a small budget, people like you and people who are the members of the press and audience don't think it's solo lead. So yeah, basically you're saying that I'm not doing a mainstream commercial film dancing around trees. So yeah, I'm not doing that. I'm very single. It's very painful. Don't ask me that question. No, I think no, never. I've been single for so long. Right now, if something like that happens, I'd probably start dating the first person who asked me to date him. But no, I don't go to bars that often. Only place you'll find me is airports, airplanes, gyms, or yoga houses. So yeah, that's where you can find me apart from when I'm working. I don't drink. A lot of people don't know that about me. I don't drink at all. Like, I'm only sipping on coffee. So have I been caught? No, and also I've not lived with my parents for almost 17 years now. So I think from the time that I was eligible enough to drink or rich enough to buy myself a drink, I've been living alone. John and Bipasha, for sure. Like, I was just like, it's almost like they're made for each other so much that they were together for so long, they almost started looking like each other. Hot, but both of them. Actors are not my thing. No, I mean, like, if you're talking about different body types and having, you know, your own body image and self-worth and all of that, and I think that it's a thing in your head. I feel I'm working more now than when I was, according to people, looking perfect in a bikini. And to say that, I don't think I look imperfect. I don't think anybody looks imperfect. I think nobody has a right to judge what's normal and not and what's not. Who describes what's normal? Buying a tag size 6 or buying a tag size 12 or buying a tag size 0. These are all things that are created by us. I feel like it's very important that people should just be able to live and breathe. At the end of the day, we're all going to wear a bikini and swim in the same ocean. We're all going to get the same sun is going to give us, you know, a beautiful tan or a, you know, whatever we need as far as a day off is concerned. So, yeah, I mean, we're nobody to curb anyone's style. Like, there are different faces, there are different bodies, and we should always be proud of them. All kind of hard to say, but I'm not the kind of person who would ever want to be like mean to anyone. So I struggle a little bit with KRK, but he's not an actor. So I don't know if I've answered your question. Definitely like a good person, because now I can pay my bills. So I'm fine. Companionship. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.